not the Hobgoblin.
How observant you are! No, I'm not the Hobgoblin, Meddler. I'm the Green Goblin. Not that you'll live long enough for it to matter.
This goblin's got super strength.
It's a bird. It's a plane. It's Green Goblin and Mary Jane. Today we take a look at the Marvel Comics Spider-Man, Green Goblin and Mary Jane Watson 2-pack. Hey, what's up guys, and welcome back to Fig Noon's Figures. It's your guy Fig Noon, and we're back today with another figure review. Today it's the Spider-Man animated series Green Goblin and Mary Jane Watson figures. We've gotten a few figures now from this line. The Spider-Man symbiote suit with the Carnage figure. Wasn't really feeling the Carnage. We got that Doc Ock and Aunt May. Really wasn't feeling Aunt May. But with these figures here, I think we're getting two really decent figures. We got that Green Goblin figure a few years ago with the bugged out eyes. This one looks to be a real upgrade. And then of course we're getting Mary Jane. You know, I don't have a Mary Jane in my collection, so I'm excited to get this. I was always a big fan of Mary Jane, you know. She was my main thing. She made me feel all right. She made my heart sing. And then the Green Goblin, you know, he was always one of my earliest memories of villains on that show. I remember thinking to myself, hey, Harry, man, come get your dad. I think he's had too much to drink. And it turns out he was. He was sipping on some Scissorum. Let's go ahead and take a look at the box. You can see what we're working with here. This artwork looks really good. Looks pretty close to what we got there on the cartoon. Here on the side of the box, we get some more images here of the Green Goblin and Mary Jane. You can see he's throwing that flaming pumpkin. Here on the back, we get some 3D renders of the figures. On this side, we get the VHS-style box design that we've already seen with some of the X-Men and some of the other Spider-Man figures. And so with no further ado, guys, go slap on your purple stocking cap, light on those pointy boots, and get ready for another monster hit of 90s nostalgia with the Spider-Man animated series, Green Goblin and Mary Jane Watson 2-pack. Here they are, guys, fresh out of the box, Mary Jane and the Green Goblin. Right off the bat, I do like the way these figures look. I think Mary Jane has a great look on her face. The colors really pop out. They give it that animated look. Some interesting things going on here with the Green Goblin. We'll talk about that here in a minute. They do come with a few accessories, so let's go ahead and take a look at those real quick before we go in for a closer look. All right, so let's take a look at those accessories, starting off with Mary Jane. She comes with a closed fist and a relaxed hand right out the box, and you can see she comes with another one of these relaxed hands for the left hand. She's also going to come with a closed fist for her right hand. So depending on how you want her to look, you can rock with these. The Green Goblin, he comes with this jack-o'-lantern bomb. You can see there's like some green stuff emitting there from the inside of it. He's got the green paint on the eyes and the mouth. Taking a look at the back of this thing, it's got a little bit of like a dark orange paint to it. It's not really that bright orange that we've seen with some of the other releases. I do like this though. We're gonna throw it in his hand here in a second. And of course we get the Green Goblin glider. You can see we're rocking with the purple paint this time. It's got some yellow paint there on the eyes. Here's the bottom of the glider. If you have one of these stands, you can go ahead and attach it there so you can kind of be hovering in the air. Of course, he has the holes here to slide his boots into so you can have him standing on this thing. Here's a look at the top of the glider. It's got kind of a matte purple finish to it. Here he's got the turbine on the back. And then we're going to get an additional head sculpt for the Green Goblin. I do like what they did here with some of the facial lines that are going on. Some of the wrinkles look nice. The only thing is his eyes look kind of, it looks almost like he's wearing like mascara. They kind of overdid it just a little bit on the lining around his eyes. Here on the hair, you can see he has some molding there as well. He's got those red lines in there. I used to wonder when I was a kid why they had those on the cartoon. I guess it's supposed to be like the waves in his hair. And then he's getting kind of like some dark circles, it looks like, under his eyes. I guess that's what happens when you go bad. You know, when you turn evil, you start to get those really dark, sinister circles. Then last but not least for the accessories, of course, we're going to get the satchel.
You're not really wearing that, are you?
It's where I keep all my things. I get a lot of compliments on this. Plus, it's not a man purse. It's called a satchel.
It's all green, but it has some gold paint here on the buckle. You can see some of the design work, some of the little details here on the satchel. You get like the button, the stitching, this little latch here. Some more green paint here on the other side. Nothing too fancy. That's going to do it for accessories. Let's go ahead and take a closer look now at our figure. All right, so let's go ahead and check out this Mary Jane figure starting off here at the head. This looks pretty close to what we got there in the cartoon. She's got some red lipstick, the dark eyeliner with that really red fiery hair that she has. Some nice sculpting as it goes kind of down her back here. A little bit of shadowing here. They did that. I think that's a nice effect. It's kind of hard to see, but it is under there. Maybe if I pop off the head, you can have a better look. And you see right here. It's just kind of got a little bit of this shadowing. Pop the head back on. She's got on her classic outfit from the show, the purple top here with the yellow sweater. You can see on the buttons, they did kind of like this little effect where they painted like the side of the button to make it cast a shadow. Down here, she's got the blue jeans. She's got the classic brown boots going on. A little bit of detail here on the boots, you can see. Nothing too crazy though. Taking a look at the back of the figure, we get some stitch work here on the pockets. I feel like this is a much better head sculpt than what we got there with Aunt May. I feel a lot more satisfied with this. She feels like she stands up a lot easier too. The Aunt May legs were just like those gummy Jean Grey legs, but with the skirt. This just feels a lot better to me. It looks a lot better. And now that we're getting that civilian Peter Parker, I mean, this is just gonna be a match made in heaven. Out of all the female characters on the show, she's definitely my favorite. Let's go ahead and have a look now at the Green Goblin. Okay, so here's the Green Goblin, and let's go ahead and check out this head. Wow, this looks a lot better than that other Green Goblin we got. The other eyes were just super bugged out. Dude was on PCP for show. Now, you see here, the pupils are a little bit smaller. We still get the fangs. We got the pointy super scroll ears going on, the long stocking cap. We've seen so many versions of the Green Goblin done thus far. Is this the best one yet? I don't know. I think this one might be making a run for its money. You get like this loose hooded thing. We've seen this done before with some of the other Marvel figures. Really bright green paint just really pops out. I think it meshes with this purple just perfectly. One thing I did notice though is he's got like a different color bottoms here than the top of the purple. He does come with this belt. The belt moves around a little bit. It isn't exactly molded to the body, but it does feel like it's really tight to the body. A little bit of gold paint there to shine off of it. He's got the purple boots. Now you don't see any of the scaling. I notice now when we look at the box, you can see they got like scales here on his body. But when you look at the actual figure, he's just really nice and smooth. There is no scaling to him to give him any kind of reptilian look. Here on the gloves, we get a little bit of a cut here, just at the top of the gloves, just a little bit. You get the cuffs here, down here at the boot. Nice and pointy little elf boots that he's got going on. But these actually come in handy when it comes to hooking them inside that glider. Here's a look at the back of the figure. He does have a hole here for a peg. That'd probably help you kind of stand this guy up when he's on that glider. Similar body that we've seen from the other Hobgoblin figure that was released a while back. So not really any upgrades as far as the body, but definitely an upgrade as far as the head. Let's go ahead and have a look at the articulation before we jump into some comparison. Okay, so for the articulation here on the Mary Jane Watson figure, she does have long, hard, plasticky hair, right? So her head can't really go back too far. It can look down about that much. She does have a little tilt to it. You could do the full 360. The arms go up about this much. Single jointed elbows here. Swivel here at the wrist with the hinge. Diaphragm joint here. We can crunch back about that much back. Crunch back about this much forward. Not really too far as forward. Here at the waist, this is all one piece. You're not really gonna be able to swivel it back and forth. I really don't like that. You can't kick forward about this much. Can't even kick back at all because of the way that the pants are cut. But you do get a cut here at the thigh. Double jointed pinless knees. There is a cut down here at the boot. You get a hinge down here at the ankle, and there is some nice ankle pivot. So some decent but not great articulation for a female figure. Let's have a look at the articulation on the Green Goblin. Okay, now for the articulation on our friend, the Green Goblin. His head does have a hinge on a ball joint, so that is nice. We didn't get that with Mary Jane. So his head can go back about that far, go down about that far. Let's check out the tilt on him. Pretty nice, full 360 here. The arms can go up about this high. He does have a cut here at the bicep, double jointed elbows, swivel here at the wrist with the hinge. You get this ab crunch here for the Green Goblin. He can go back about that far. Go forward about this much. We do get a swivel here at the waist. His legs can do a full split. We do get a cut here at the thigh, double jointed knees here. We do get a cut here at the boot. We get a hinge down here at the ankle, and he does have some ankle pivot as well. We've seen this articulation already, pretty basic stuff. Let's jump into some comparison. Okay, so for our first comparison, we have the Doc Ock figure, also from the animated series line. We reviewed this guy just a couple of weeks ago. You can go back and check it out. I really like the way all these figures are looking so far. Hopefully we keep getting some more. Here we have the Green Goblin and Mary Jane next to Kurt Connors, aka Dr. Lizard. And here we have MJ and Double G next to the Hammerhead figure. Go with some more animated series goodness. We have Wolverine from the X-Men animated series line. One thing we got here with these figures that we didn't see here is the cell shading. I don't know, what do you guys think? Should we get cell shading on these figures? I know we got the one cell shaded Spider-Man, but we didn't see that anywhere else. And speaking of cell shading, here he is, the cell shaded Spider-Man. All Alright, for our last comparison, we have the Diamond Select Green Goblin next to the Hasbro Green Goblin. This one's based off the comics. This one's based, of course, off the animated series. So you got a whole different goblin glider here. This one's kind of plain. It's got more of a metallic wash to it. They both come with the jack-o'-lantern bombs. Some similarities there you can see with the satchel. This has more kind of that detailed reptilian look there on the skin. A lot larger in scale. Just thought I'd give you guys a look. Let's jump into Fig's final thoughts. Okay, so for my final thoughts on the Spider-Man animated series, Green Goblin and Mary Jane 2-pack, a lot of people think this isn't an essential cop, but I think it kind of is. In my opinion, this might be the best Green Goblin that we've gotten from Marvel Legends so far. Plus the Mary Jane figure, I mean, it looks just like her. What more do you want? The green and purple really pop out on that Green Goblin. The face is definitely an upgrade. The glider looks pretty good. I wish we could have got a stand to go with that thing. I didn't expect a whole lot of accessories for Mary Jane. We only get 2 extra hands. Not surprising, but maybe another head would have been nice for, you know, some kind of terrified look or something. The articulation as far as the Green Goblin isn't anything we haven't seen before. It's the same body as the Hobgoblin figure. And the articulation on the Mary Jane figure, I don't know, these female figures always leave something to be desired. Price point at a little bit over $50 for this 2-pack. I'd say that's becoming the norm now for what we're getting from Marvel Legends. With all that being said, I'm going to give this 2-pack a rating of 8 out of 10 figs. Look, sure hope you guys enjoyed this review, and if you did, make sure to hit that like button for me, and also make sure to subscribe for even more reviews. That's gonna wrap it up for this one, but as always, thanks for watching. We'll see you guys next time. It's your guy Fig Newton. Fig Newton. Ow. Do it, man.